context of our government's commitment to strengthening and valuing the profession. It is a no-brainer that we cannot get these education outcomes of 5 out of 5 kids being successful if they are not being taught by good quality teaching and good quality educational leadership. And so how we construct or facilitate or support or is a series of festivals of education in Auckland, in Wellington, and in Christchurch. And again, with the intention that we both have the opportunity to recognise and celebrate what is happening in the education space, what parents can see and be a part of, and what experience young people are having. And these will be hosted in March around the International Summit. I mean, it'll be infectious. Everybody in that month won't be able to help but talk about what a great education must be in this country. You know, they won't be sitting next to each other, sitting in lattes at cafes, talking about or whatever. I say that with a little bit of this because when I came home after we worked so hard to get selected to host the World Cup of Education, the International Summit, and I put out a press statement and said, ta-da! We beat Canada, we beat Belgium, we beat Hong Kong to get this, to host this event. Nobody cared. Nobody. But then a week later, we won the hosting rights of three games. Doves were set free. Crackers were let off. That's what we want to create. So when I say the World Cup of Education, I absolutely mean that. Remember the sizzle, the excitement, the flash crackers, the country's complete focus. So the excitement of that is what we want to try and recapture and ignite in the interest of education and in the service of the work. So I'm now going to invite Terry Bates to speak, it's quite apart from anything else. The ministry officials at the back of the room are going. So, thank you all very much.